Hello dear students, I hope all of you are doing well at home. Today we will learn History Chapter 2, which is Rise of Gandhi and the Freedom Movement of India. So in this chapter we'll be learning about Gandhiji's role in the various movement which took place in India. Okay, so as we all know that Gandhiji was born on 2nd October 1869 at Porbandar, Gujarat. Now in 1888, he went to England to carry out his law study, and after completing his study, he came back to India in 1891. And from 1891 to 1893, he stayed in India and practiced law in Rajkot and Mumbai. In 1893, he went to Natal, South Africa, and stayed there for about 21 years in South Africa. The main reason behind his staying there in South Africa was because he wanted to fight for the cause of the Indians who were facing discrimination. The very incident which shook him was when he was traveling by train to Pretoria. On the way, he was caught carrying first class ticket as Indians over there, or the blacks in South Africa, were not allowed to sit in the first class compartment. So Gandhiji, even though he was carrying the first class compartment tickets, he was thrown from the train at Pietermaritzburg in the middle of the night along with his luggage. Now this very incident was really embarrassing for Gandhiji, but this incident encouraged Gandhiji and motivated him, and he realized that he had to stay in South Africa to fight for the cause of the Indians, because he felt that like him, there might be many Indians who might be suffering in the same way. So now staying in South Africa, he started this political association called Natal Indian Congress. This is basically meant to increase his strength in South Africa. He also introduced a newspaper called Indian Opinion, and in this newspaper, Gandhiji made all the Indians who were suffering or who were humiliated at some point of time in South Africa to redress their grievances through this newspaper. They wanted all their opinions or all the problems which they face in South Africa were written down in this paper called Indian Opinion. And now there was a region called Transvaal Province, which is a British colony in South Africa, and Gandhiji found that the Indians were stopped from entering this particular region. They were discriminated. Now another problem which the Indians in South Africa were facing were relating to the Indian marriages. Now in South Africa, the Indians, either Hindus or Muslims, they were forced to register their marriage and also marry according to the Christian rites. Now it was said that if they marry according to their own religion, their marriage will be considered as invalid. Now this was a law over there, and so Gandhiji felt that this law was completely against humanity, and he fought for this. Now after 7 years of struggle in South Africa, finally he entered into a contract with the South African government, where it was agreed that the South African government will not be pressurizing the Indians to marry according to Christian rites, but yes, they have to register their marriages. So it was agreed between Gandhiji and the South African government. But later on, he found that the Indians were pressurized to marry according to the Christian rites, even though the agreement has been entered before. So this made Gandhiji to put pressure on the government, and at that point of time, about 6,000 to 7,000 workers who were working in South Africa, they went on for a strike and pressurized the government. At the same time, the concept of non-violence adopted by Gandhiji in South Africa completely impressed the South African government. So the concept of Satyagraha was first applied by Gandhiji in South Africa. So in this regard, for fighting against these marriages, he was kept in jail for a period of 9 months, but finally after 9 months he was released from jail under this Indian Relief Act of 1914, where it was confirmed that the South African government will not pressurize the Indians anymore for marrying according to Christian rites, but yes, they have to register their marriages. Now the concept of Satyagraha, which Gandhiji developed, it has a meaning. So Satya means truth, and agraha means adherence or holding fast. That means fighting for truth, standing for it. If you know that something is true, you will stand for it and you will fight for it. Okay. Now we have these two writers, Thoreau and Leo Tolstoy. Thoreau is an American writer and Leo Tolstoy is a Russian writer. Now Gandhiji while developing this concept of satyagraha, was completely impressed by the writings of these two writers, where the concept of satyagraha is involved, which talks about empirical thinking and thus the strength of the spirit. So this particular writers have inspired Gandhiji to carry out for the concept of satyagraha. Now, in 1915, Gandhiji returned back to India after fighting for the cause of the Indians in South Africa. So by that time, already the First World War had started by 1914. So now, after coming to India, he did not sit quietly, but after coming back from South Africa, he was already a prepared leader. So after coming over there, he handles the local disputes in Champaran, North Bihar, Khera, Gujarat, and Ahmedabad. Okay. So in Champaran, North Bihar, he fought for the cause of the peasants who were forced by the British government to plant indigo in place of the food crops. Now this very thing made Gandhiji really angry, because he found that it was an injustice to the peasants in Champaran. So that's why he fought for the cause of the peasants there. And in Khera, Gujarat, he fought for the cause of the peasants who were made to pay taxes even in cases when their crops failed. So he fought for them, demanding that taxes should not be charged in those years when the crops actually failed. Now in other cases, in Ahmedabad, he fought for the cause of the mill workers against the mill owners who were exploiting them and who were not paying the mill workers reasonable amount of money. So after coming back to India, he handled this three disputes. Now during this point of time, okay, all the disputes were handled around 1917 to 18, and in 1917 there was this Russian Revolution of 1917, which took place in Russia, where Tsar Nicholas II was overthrown by the common people and the Bolshevik government was formed. So this very thing, this very news reached the ears of the Indians way back in India, and it encouraged the Indians, and they started having this feeling that maybe if the common people in Russia can overthrow the Tsar, which is an emperor or a king, then the common people in India can also do the same by overthrowing the British government. So by this time, the people in India were started having the sentiments of coming together and fighting for their own causes. So in all of these local disputes, you will find that it was only the mass participation, that means participation of the people along with Gandhiji in the movement, which made it successful. Next, we have the Rowlatt Act 1919. So in 1917, Governor General Lord Chelmsford formed a committee under the chairmanship of Justice Sidney Rowlatt and asked him to form a legislation against the revolutionary activities which was taking place in India. So in 1919, the British Parliament passed an act which is called the Rowlatt Act of 1919, wherein it was decided that any Indians who were suspected of being involved in revolutionary activities, which means any activities against the government, will be caught and kept in jail for a period of 2 years without any trials. Now, this particular act came as a shock for Gandhiji. He was really angry, okay, because this time he found that this particular act has spoiled the life of many Indians who were unnecessarily caught only on the basis of suspect. Now, at the same time, the First World War, which was started in 1914, during that time, when Gandhiji returned back to India in 1915, the British government tried to convince Gandhiji and the other leaders to participate in the First World War, assuring that they will be given independence after the First World War. But after, when the First World War ended in 1918, the British government showed no attitude of interest. They did not show any interest of giving independence to India. So this very thing angered Gandhiji, and at the same time, the starting of this Rowlatt Act angered Gandhiji a lot. And that's why against this Rowlatt Act, he started the Satyagraha, or which is also called non-violence movement, on 6th April 1919. So now here he applied the concept of Satyagraha, which he first used in South Africa. Okay. So here, as he started the movement, he made it clear that Satyagraha should be adopted by every Indian as a religious movement. Just like we are dedicated towards our religion, every Indian should also be dedicated towards the principle of Satyagraha. And he made it quite clear, and he also confirmed that this particular concept, it is talking about penance and purification. Now, purification talks about purifying your soul or purifying your wrongdoings. and it can be only done through penance. Now, penance means inflicting punishment on oneself because of the wrongdoing of oneself, or maybe because of the wrongdoing of others. Now, penance here, it does not talk about any sort of physical injuries, but Gandhiji talks about fasting, which he feels is a good way of releasing ourselves from all the evil intentions that we have. Now, this particular movement, which is Satyagraha movement, was not successful, but it rose Gandhiji as a very able leader and people started knowing Gandhiji at the national level. Now, at this time when the Satyagraha movement was going on, just within a week in Punjab, there was an incident which is the Jallianwala Bagh massacre. Okay, now before this, on 10th April 1919, two of the popular leaders of Punjab, Dr. Saifuddin and Dr. Khichli, they were arrested and they were deported from Amritsar. Now, since these two popular leaders were a favorite of the people of Punjab, they became so sad and they decided to conduct a public meeting in Jallianwala Bagh on 13th April 1919. So, on this particular day, they all decided, the leaders and the people decided to gather over there to decide what can be done to get back their leaders. Now, when this meeting were planned, General Reginald Dyer, he already had the idea about this public meeting to be conducted in the Jallianwala Bagh. But then, he did not stop them. So, the day came and finally the meeting was about to start. So, this particular bagh had all walls enclosed on all the sides. It was all high walls and there was just a small entrance from where they entered. So, now, suddenly as the leaders were starting their meeting, General Reginald Dyer entered from the entrance along with the troops and ordered the troops to surround the people who were ready for the meeting. And he ordered the troops to fire on the innocent people. So in this incident, hundreds of lives were lost and many other people, those who did not die because of firing, they died because of stampede. Now in this situation, it is said that General Reginald Dyer, he used this law called martial law. Now, this is a law which is applied by the highest military ranking and this is applied only in the situations of emergency. When they feel that the present government is not in a position to make decisions, then only the military interference will be done. So, he said he applied this law by showing emergency, by telling the government and convincing the government that this is a situation of emergency for the country because these people have been gathering to plan and plot against the government. So by showing this, he tried to prove his innocence. Now, Lord Hunter was appointed for the purpose of inquiring into this matter. In this situation, the British government tried to show their innocence, tried to show that they are justice-loving people and appointed Lord Hunter for the same. So now, when the trials and evidences were put up, finally, at the end, General Reginald Dyer was absolved from guilt. That means he was freed from all the accusations made on him. And the only punishment that he got was he only lost his positions. So this very thing angered the Indians and Gandhiji and the Indians were very angry with this decision made by the British government. So at this point of time, even Rabindranath Tagore, he renounced his knighthood title because he was really angry and in order to show that he was against the government's decision of justice, he rejected the knighthood title which was offered to him. So from today's class, we have learned how Gandhiji has played a very great role in Natal, South Africa, and also after returning back to India in 1915, how he took part in the local disputes in Champaran, Khera and Ahmedabad, and how the incident of the First World War and Roller Act angered Gandhiji and he was compelled to start the first movement at the national level, which is called the Satyagraha or Non-Violence Movement. And after that, we have seen how the Jallianwala massacre took place and how General Reginald Dyer has applied martial law for the same. So in the next class, we'll be learning about Khilafat Movement and Non-Cooperation Movement and harder. Until then, see you in the next class. Thank you.
Stay home, stay safe, do it for yourselves, do it for your family, do it for India. Let's break the chain of COVID-19. Hum hum ye kamyab, Jai Hind.